Yo, what's going on, guys? So before the video starts today, I'm actually doing an advertisement for myself. It's getting a lot colder out there, even in Texas, it's getting cold enough to be wearing a hoodie. But of course, the Jumping Jay has me covered. This hoodie is actually available right now on my merch website. We got t-shirts. You want a blue t-shirt? I got you. You're more of a white t-shirt type of person? I got you. Forest green? Like me, you know, I love forest green. I got you. This is actually the comfort fit tee. I'm telling you, if you can spend the extra $5, I kept the prices very affordable in my opinion. If you can spend the extra $5, you know, it's definitely worth it for me. More breathable type of material than the other one that's just more of a cotton. Blue, I got you. Firefighter, got you. And of course, the classic black always looks nice. I also got 6 sweatshirts if you're not the hoodie type of person. And I got stuff for everybody. I got stuff for men. I got stuff for women. I got stuff for kids. I just listed a Jamari polo where it's this logo, but it's more like the polo size if that's more your thing. So all that's on the website. It's going to be the first link down in the description. I want to thank you guys for always supporting. And if you can't buy merch or you don't want to buy merch, you watching the videos is definitely enough for me. So thank you guys for watching as always, and I hope you appreciate this video because it's gonna get pretty deep. So get some popcorn. Peace. So recently there's been a lot of people outing quite a few men in the Hollywood industry as both creeps and groomers, specifically in the DMs of young women. And I'm not talking young like early 20s, not even 18. I'm talking about 14, 15, and 16 years old. Disgusting. This list of alleged creeps and potential groomers includes names like Chris D'Elia, the guy from The Fault in Our Stars, and most recently white rapper Hoodie Allen. I'm going to be focusing in on this man today because I used to listen to his music, attended a few of his concerts back in high school with some, of course, teenage girls at the time, and this story just kind of made my jaw drop. So like I said, get your popcorn, get a beverage, get your blankie. So like I love to say, I was actually one of the first people to hear about this dude Hoodie Allen back in around 2011 when I heard a song called You Are Not a Robot on a Modern Warfare 2 montage. And so I started listening to this and a few of his other tracks, and I remember thinking he was fresh and new. This was a new style of pop that I had never heard anything like before. Keep in mind, at this time I was only around 13 years old. And I love looking for the latest YouTube rappers. There were a lot of them who, looking back at the time, was simply hot garbage. But honestly, there was something about this Hoodie guy that separated him from the pack. He had a kind of unique internet star-like quality about him. This shit is dodgeball, homie, you can pick me. It was like watching your accountant rap or something, you know, you just had to see this. And don't get me wrong, this wasn't like my go-to music or anything like that, but it was a nice suburban pop rap that was super white and the girls in my hometown liked to play it, so why not? Throughout the years, he kept making more music and his cult-like fanbase started growing bigger and bigger, putting him on the map as he became one of the first independent artists to climb up the iTunes and Billboard charts through the word of internet mouth, catching the attention of the likes of Chitty Bang and Ed Sheeran pretty early on. And this is when he really attempted to separate himself from the class of internet rappers that was doing all this douchey frat rap, trying to follow the career trajectory of the late great Mac Miller and break out the frat rap scene. And don't get me wrong right here, guys, I am not comparing Hoodie Allen, garbage Hoodie Allen, to the legendary Mac Miller. I'm just saying that's what he was going for. But back at that time though, around 2012, I was all here for it. I mean, everything in rap was corny back in the early 2000s. I thought I wanted to go to Texas A&M. You know, it was crazy times. And this dude Hoodie, he was in my headphones. So like I said, I found him early on. He was a cool guy. He had some good songs. And it was kind of like I had found this diamond in the rough. This good guy that liked to interact with his fans through social media. I remember he was one of the first people that was ever doing live streams on YouTube, tour vlogs, and he was always on Twitter all day. Like, when I say all day, I mean all fucking day. The dude has over 200,000 tweets. If that doesn't scream loser, I don't know what does. But anyways, I caught him so early that, like I said in the other video, we're actually friends on Facebook. I had him back in around 2011, I would say, and we even interacted for a little while through private message, both on Facebook and through Twitter. Though you can't see what he said anymore because in the light of all this fire, and with so many people coming forward with allegations of both grooming and very inappropriate behavior involving minors at his concerts, I think Hoodie decided it was best to cover his tracks and delete his old Facebook. But at that time, I do remember though, I was surprised he was responding to me out of all these people trying to contact him. But it seemed like this is what he liked to do, was interact with his little cult community of teenage girls and suburban white kids all day every day, and they loved it. These were the same people buying his hard copies of his CDs, going to his shows, paying for his merch and meet and greet tickets, traveling to different cities for these Apple employee looking motherfuckers. And I think for a lot of them, this hoodie mob, as he called them, was sort of a safe space free from judgment a lot of people were facing on a day-to-day basis. And while I was never personally involved in the hoodie mob activity, I remember knowing some people who were, and I remember these people who were also underage were interacting with this guy Hoodie Allen on a very personal level. I'm talking about messaging him everyday type shit. It's like he had this Rolodex of young girls on his Twitter that he knew were showing up to his shows every night in different cities, all because they would message back and forth on Twitter all day every single day. He would use some of them for that just so he could like lock in their fandom, and other ones he wanted to have a more romantic relationship with. And eventually, like I said, I even went to see him in concert around 3 times during high school when I was around 16 to 18 years old, from my sophomore to my senior year, I would say. And I really only went because I had some other friends who really liked to go see him, hint hint, all teenage girls around 15 to 17 years old. So at these concerts, it would be me and all these girls, ages ranging from, I don't know, 10 to 17, maybe some 18 to 19 to 20 year olds, but definitely not many. Maybe like 5% men at most, and this was the demographic of the show. There was more braces in that place than orthodontist office on a Tuesday afternoon. It was straight up like a middle school dance up in there. I mean, check out this picture of me and one of my friends from high school in one of these Hoodie Allen crowds. What the fuck? And there we saw a Hoodie up there dancing and shaking around like the man-child he is, while these teenage girls crowded and shoved each other out of the way to get their beloved Twitter god's attention. I'm telling you, he was like a god to these young girls. He had them eating out of the palm of his hand. To them, it was almost like watching fucking Elvis as he surfed the crowd and threw cakes on motherfuckers. He had given them attention online, and now these girls, who were often suffering from low self-esteem, wanted to get his attention in real life. He knew this, and I believed he used his position of power to manipulate these young girls. I mean, just look at one of these testimonies that one of his victims left on Twitter. If this isn't grooming, I don't know what is. So she says, "My story is similar to Sarah's in that I was a teenager when I started interacting with H. I was told that we could only be friends until I was 18, but inappropriate comments were always made. I grew up with him always being in my DMs or in my Snapchat. He would send me flirty messages, ask for pics, and other things that I overlooked because I love having his attention. For me, it was a feeling so special. It went on for 6+ years. Even when I was dating someone, it didn't matter. Night times were when he'd come into my messages and treat me like I was special. He would get mad at me for interacting with other mob members and constantly told me that they were drama. I see now that he wanted to make sure I kept quiet about our little more than friends relationship. It was to the point where I really thought that someday we might be together. That's how brainwashed I was. I was the typical tour bus goer, and I even went to hotel rooms that the crew stayed in for college/small shows. All of this was so normal to me, but looking back, he used me. When I needed him, he wasn't there, but when he needed me, I was expected to be there to help. He turned me against certain people and always made sure I kept my mouth shut about him and I. He used to get so jealous of other men that it made me cry, and my college friends always thought it was so strange that this man had such a strong influence over me." Yeah, that sounds like a cult. "The ones who met him were always so confused why he acted the way he did towards me when he was in a relationship, but I was too blind to see it or even really care because I was, quote unquote, his girl." Apparently a direct quote from him. And I really just don't get it. Like, this guy's just a straight up creep, to be honest. You're rich, you're famous, you could probably easily get girls your age, you're successful, and you're still messaging all these teenage girls. I mean, what's really wrong with you, bro? Whether it was to buy tickets and merch, or to get a little action at the end of the show, it was all the same thing, just using his fans. When you're up on stage jumping rope with a bunch of training bras and A-cups, I think you got something wrong with you, sir. And I remember at that age though, like 17 years old, I was very impressed and thinking this guy was cool. But now that I'm a 23-year-old man, thinking of a then 26-year-old man interacting with all these kids up to 13 years younger than him in both private message and in person, it was all really fucking weird. I mean, I get wanting to connect to your fan base, but this guy took things way too far. I'm someone who gets messages from kids and teen girls all the time who like my YouTube channel. And needless to say, I usually don't even reply, and even if I do, it's just with something like thank you or I appreciate it. But if it's anything too crazy, I just do not reply. I'm not the type of person that's gonna be telling these kids I love them too and shit like that. I just say, "Oh, I appreciate it, buddy. Now run along, little Johnny." And it's not that I don't appreciate these people. It's just, I feel it's inappropriate for us to be DMing in this way, having full-on conversations conversations. We have nothing to talk about privately, I'm a grown man. And that's why this story is extra fucked up to me, because I know how easy it is not to abuse your power and to not be a creep. And in the end, this whole situation just perplexed me. This hoodie guy seemed like he was the type of person that was cool and possibly normal at the start of his career, but he could never grow up, and that's why him and his friends were doing all this weird shit with underage women both online and in person. I mean, the guy even has a song called
Act My Age,
where he talks about how he just wants to stay young forever and party and play in the pool. These fans who were literally keeping the lights on, they were keeping food on Hoodie's table, have now all turned their backs on this man. The hoodie mob that he created has actually now become an angry mob, demanding further explanation and answers, especially after he responded by throwing his bandmates under the bus and not addressing a single one of the allegations against himself. And that was 3 months ago. Since then, the guy hasn't been heard from. What a fucking coward. And the worst part about it is they felt like they could trust this guy. They felt like he was their friend. He created this small community of people who felt comfortable around each other. And I hate to say it, but I think this guy created an online cult of teenage girls. And that's just fucked up. For you, Hoodie, I think it's safe to say your rap career is over. Good luck in the accounting field or at McDonald's, or wherever the fuck you end up working. I just hope to God that you won't be around any girls wearing push-up bras. And I'll leave you guys with this. Isn't it ironic that a rapper who named himself after Woody Allen, possibly the most notorious groomer in the world, and now this information comes out about him? Life really is very full circle sometimes, guys.